attorney lead generation services. Is paying per lead the right choice for your firm? So this is an important topic because obviously leads and cases are the lifeblood of law firms. However, sometimes the short-term decision isn't always the best long-term decision. So there's tons of third-party sites that attorneys can use to generate leads from. You have AVVO, you have FindLaw, you have Nolo, you have lawyers.com, you have Four Legal Leads. You have all these different websites that lawyers can either pay for an advertisement on as a directory, or they can actually pay per phone call or per lead from these third-party sites. So the first thing I want you to keep in mind is the difference between clients calling you directly, okay, versus potential clients that reach out through a third-party website that, how do I put this, don't know what firm they're reaching out to. So just know your close rate is going to be much higher when leads are already introduced to your company, to your brand, to your law firm's brand, and then choose to call you, especially after they looked at your reviews and stuff like that. Then just a blind submission on a third-party site, you get a notification, and then you talk to them as some random lawyer, one of five that are calling them back after they submit their information. So just understand there's a trade-off. You may pay less per lead, but you also may have to field 10 times as many calls to get an actual case from it because there's not that brand trust buildup. Another thing to keep in mind is the quality of cases. So I want you to think of your practice area. Just know that if you're in high-end family law, you know, people are not going to be coming in through third-party sites as often as, for example, soft tissue auto accident injuries, right? So keep in mind, the higher the net worth individual you're looking to target is, the more likely you're going to have to do your own marketing to attract that person versus buying a high-end lead, which almost never works. So keep in mind the niche you're in. But again, the operational bottleneck is a very important component here. I personally, I'd rather spend $700 per lead and, you know, turn one in every two leads. I mean, when a client reaches out to us, we have a 55% close rate because we practice what we preach. We build a brand, we have good reviews. So when people reach out to us, they've already put in their consideration. So we close about 55% of calls, which is awesome for my sales team because then they actually treat those calls as high value all the time when people call in for our company. So for you, you have to make the decision. Are you gonna be a mass numbers practice, or are you looking for a lower volume of phone calls, a higher percentage of which actually turn into cases? Another thing is to think about the data trade-off. Data trade-off. So what I mean by that is when you invest money in a third-party website to generate leads for your law firm, just know you're giving up a big key to your future marketing endeavors. Best short-term solution is not always the best long-term solution. So you're giving up your data. When you own the source of where your leads come from and you're, you know, funneling all your leads through your website, you have Google Analytics set up, and you know, you're using separate ClickFunnels landing pages for your lead flows. You can pixel everyone. You can create lookalike audiences in Facebook to show ads to people who are in similar situations to those who are becoming high quality cases for you. So keep in mind, there's a trade-off there. When you go and, you know, dump your money in a third-party website for someone to blindly call your firm for a free consultation, you don't get really any data from that. So there's a trade-off there, and there's another trade-off, which is, are you doing this? Are you investing in attorney lead generation services out of a short-term need to put a Band-Aid over a deep wound in your company's SEO and bigger online marketing strategy? Are you pushing off getting that new website built? Are you pushing off your next SEO initiative because you know it's gonna take 4 or more months to see results from it? And are you just putting a Band-Aid on a deeper wound in your firm's marketing strategy? This is a big thing I want you to think of, because if buying leads causes you to push off the important but not urgent tasks for your firm for another year, you probably want to go through the pain I know this sounds weird saying this, but you probably want to go through the pain of not buying leads so that you're forced to build a more robust marketing system for your firm that actually works for the long term. So keep all these in consideration if you're considering an attorney lead generation service. If you like this video, or you want more content like this, then be sure to like this video and leave a comment if you have any questions. But make sure to subscribe to this channel so you get future notifications when these videos come out. And I hope this was helpful for you. Thanks.